This is Thomas Allen, who's going to play Germont, and Ileana Cotrubas, who you've already met. Now, Tom, you as Germont, Papa Germont, as Ileana calls her, you sweep on full of sound and fury at the beginning of this scene. Mm. What brings you up short?
The sound and the fury, etc., this brusque entrance is a result of his typical chauvinist opinion of the kind of woman he's coming to meet. Rather surprisingly to him, he meets a woman of much greater character and dignity, shall we say, of greater strength, of backbone, if nothing else, than he'd envisaged.
Before he meets, in fact, a real woman.
Indeed, yes.
And it's that shift of power. For a moment, you're taken aback, and Violetta wins that little moment. And you can see how Verdi does that in the music. The person who alters the course of the music has the power. Listen, let me explain this in slightly more technical terms. Everyone knows the musical phrase. And everyone knows that this chord has got to be followed by this chord. So that's what you expect when Germont comes in and says,
Madamigella Valerie,
son io,
d'Alfredo il padre me vedete,
voi,
si dell'incauto che a ruina corre ammaliato da voi.
You expect to be followed by, not at all. What happens is that Violetta is annoyed by his incivility and interrupts. Instead of ammaliato da voi, we get
ammaliato da voi.
Nonna sono io, signore, ed in mia casa, io vi lascia sentite più per voi che per me.
Quai modi.
So, Ileana, you've won that bit. But of course, Germont has other shots in his locker. He has other ways of getting round.
Yes, of course, he was not prepared to find such a strong lady, and a great lady, in fact, a great woman.
Chauvinist.
Thank you. He tries to, with another car, with another trick to get his way. He wants to win the battle. Mm.
He's got one thing to say, and he's come to say it. But instead of being rude, he now tries to be polite. And again, the music shows how this works. You expect this chord to be followed by that. But Germont, listen how Germont turns that chord to another purpose. He brings her up short, like this.
Alfredo il padre, la sorte, l'avenir domanda or guide suoi due figli.
I due figli.
Sì.
You see, Germont shifted the music to this point, and now, of course, he can play his ace. He's in an opera, so he begins a tune.
Pura siccome un angelo, Iddio mi die una figlia, se al re non è carriere in sé.
Tune is very confident and four square, isn't
settled.
It? Settled. Settled. And when you discover what he wants, which is, of course, to give Alfredo up, as we've just seen in the play.
Yeah.
Your response is quite different, isn't
it? It's very fragmented, and it shows the instability of emotions of Violetta, and in fact, the instability of ill woman of consumptions. She suffers from consumptions, and I think, or we all know, that all people suffering from consumptions are very unstable emotionally, and
from the tops to the depths, from
very strong moments and to low, and so it's and this Verdi put it in wonderfully in the music.
In the music, first it's soft and then loud. Yeah,
she's just she receives such a shock now, because he's asking her to renounce of the only or the last little rest of happiness she has.
She's absolutely desperate.
Desperate,
moving from very soft moments to very loud moments, and shifting about, not like Germont's tune at all. This sort of thing. Germont can't just go on.
He would be a hard man if he was unmoved by that.
Absolutely. So what, in fact, happens to Germont now?
Well, I think similarly, his own feelings then become fragmented. He has a show of emotion, if you like, briefly anyhow, in trying to bring some kind of reason into following her argument. Then he has to try and reconstruct her life in a way. And show a possibility of another life. Certainly without his son.
That's very well said, although what you're saying, although he's very sympathetic to this.
Yes, but Violetta is a woman, or as a woman as she is, could suddenly explode in such a way, and to show her feelings so openly. And he's a little bit embarrassed.
It's unseemly behavior for a woman of the period.
And yes.
Of course, for a musician, for a composer, that's wonderful. If he's got to illustrate embarrassment, that means that what Verdi's got to do is two things. So show Germont reacting, and at the same time show Germont absolutely making sure that he's going to get his point across. So what he starts off is a very unlyrical, rather broken up phrase, and then gradually, by stages, bring up more and more lyrical phrases. Just show us how this works, Tom. First.
Bella, voi siete e giovine col tempo.
Sorry to stop you in the middle of it. We will hear the whole of this section, I promise, later. And then that's hardly a tune at all. And then this little passage, which is a little more like a tune.
Di quando le veneri il tempo
raffugate. And then the third phrase, which is even more lyrical.
Adunque, dunque, sperdasi, tal sogno seduttore, siate di mia famiglia, l'angel consolatore.
The question is, who is going to cap it? Well, of course.
Soprano.
Ileana, anyhow.
This is La Traviata, after all, and it's the soprano who caps it, with a musical and emotional reference to that tune we've already heard and know so well. With a reference to that tune, she caps Germont's argument, such as it is, by expressing an emotion. And of course, that's the thing that music is supreme at. Mm-hmm.